the Route 1 corridor has a lot of opportunity. There's a lot of revitalization and redevelopment. It's one of the few areas of Fairfax County that has not been revitalized. There's a lot of stuff happening on the west end. The south end is kind of in need, the east end. So we find that there's a lot of opportunity with mixed use and redevelopment.
I guess my main thing is traffic. So it's hard to take care of that, but that's a primary concern for me. That it takes me about an hour to get to work. Well, I take the bus, but it's still unnecessarily long, even because the bus takes Route 1, which is affected by traffic.
A lot more businesses have come upscale.
Well, they could probably put another movie theater. We really miss that. We have to go to Kingstown or over at the train station to catch a movie, but other than that, we have everything right here.
It's one of the busiest non-interstate roadways in the whole metropolitan area. And we like the fact that there would be that much traffic and it would be continuing to grow.
We think some of the greatest assets along Richmond Highway is its close proximity, especially at this end of town, to the metro. Richmond Highway also offers close proximity to DC and the major thoroughfares.
Here, I like that I'm right near the metro. I work right off the metro station. It's quiet, I like that. It's very close to Route 1, which all the stores are, so that's convenient. I can just walk there, that's convenient.
There has been talk of extending the Metro Rail south down the corridor. It currently ends at Huntington Metro Station. And so that there is that possibility. The extension of that Metro Rail down the Richmond Highway corridor will not happen anytime soon, but it definitely could happen, and if that does, that will certainly be a game changer in the area and spur a lot more new development.
We also like the fact that it gave them multiple options to be able to get in and around the whole metropolitan area, whether it was Tyson's Corner, Springfield, National Harbor. This was a unique location to provide people the ability to access those points very conveniently. And in this area, travel is such a big component on how people make a decision on where they work, live, and play. We felt this provided them the best of all the worlds.
Some of the challenges are actually finding the properties that work and working through them to get enough property to make a large enough development.
We've had the normal challenges with Mother Nature being rather rainy at the very first, but we were very fortunate with the fact that the winter season was mild beyond any expectation that we had. We've worked very well with the county in getting all the approvals. We've had our normal disagreements in trying to move it forward, but both parties are trying to get the best project that they can, and so it's been a very excellent relationship with the county.
Most of the parcels along the Richmond Highway corridor here are half-acre parcels with the smaller retail buildings situated on them. For us, we think that we need a minimum of a few acres in order to get enough mass and enough scale to create something that's significant and make an impact.
Naturally, closer to the Huntington Metro Station, that will demand more higher density use, where you could have high-rise, say, condominium buildings. Further away from the metro, you would have lower mid-rise to low-rise garden-style apartments, and of course townhouses as well, very popular.
The resident profile would be a professional in the 25 to 45 age group, predominantly probably in the 30 to 39 age group. They are professionals, but of a transitory nature. They do a lot of consulting work, they do a lot of political work, which is natural for the area. They are folks that would be working predominantly in the DC area, Fort Belvoir area, or in the Old Town Carlisle area. In addition, they would also be folks that could be entrepreneurs or are consulting work where it allows them to work out of their office, out of their home. And we've provided areas here which would allow them to be able to do that sort of consulting work from their home to their consulting job or to the office that they work for.
10 years from now, make it a little more kid friendly, maybe a nice park.
This area is really poised for a lot of great things. A lot of the buildings through here were built in the 60s and so forth. A lot of great things are happening. It's going to take time. Of course, there's a lot of activity in areas like Tyson's and other areas, but really, this area will only get better.